Hello everyone, it's time to make a freeform geode again, and for the base I used an MDF board and I taped some acetate on it, and I'm using the soft molding dough as my barrier, and on the inside side I applied a thin layer of Vaseline. I want to test it again. And yeah, let's see how it goes. I'm already started with some fire glass, and this is in the color Platinum Moonlight. Very nice fire glass. And yeah, I'm placing it on two places in the geode. First I poured some clear resin on the acetate sheet, and on top of it I'm placing the fire glass. Very nice fire glass. Not that large, but I like it. Yeah, and I want to see, because I never tested the molding dough with the Vaseline on the inside on a larger piece, so I want to test it again to see how that goes. And another color fire glass, this is the Sunstorm Gold, same size as the Platinum Moonlight, very nice on the outside. And with my steering stick I push it to the place I want it. And in this video you are going to see the first two layers. It's going to get several layers. At least, I think, 5, 6. Not sure yet, because I want it to be very thick. And the first color I'm using is a magenta Bombay ink. And I mixed some Bling It Red in it to give it some sparkle. The Bling Red from Color Art. Very nice, vibrant color. I like it. And then it can flow under the fire glass. I like that. It's transparent. So around the fire glass, it will be the light will be shining through, I hope. And next to it, the Wild Jasmine, and I mixed some Interference Violet in it to make it a lighter shade of the Wild Jasmine. It's also from Color Art. Very nice color. And next to it, the Wild Jasmine, but then I mixed nothing in it. So different shades of the same color. And I let it bleed into each other. I like that. It doesn't have to be straight lines. And the next color, that's the purple sapphire, also by Color Art. So a darker shade next to it to give it some contrast. Also on the other side. And I also want to thank some people again. I want to thank Evelyn for sending me such nice supplies. Thank you so much for that. I also want to thank Laurie and Deborah for sponsoring me. So thanks a lot if you watch this video. I can't tell you how grateful I am for that. And this is the ultraviolet of Just a Resin. Very nice sparkly color. I like it. So it's all going to be pink and purple. This geode. Totally different than I did before. And I'm also going to try to create the depth in a different way than I normally do, but I will explain that in a later stadium. And the next color is the Blue Purple by Color Obsession. Also a very nice color. No sparkle, but I like that if you combine sparkle and no sparkle. But yeah, normally you create a depth by opaque and transparent colors, but I want to do it a little bit different. I want to try something. Now I'm pushing the colors against each other so that it can bleed into each other. And this making this diode will be in several videos, because I can't do it in one video, because it gets a lot of layers. A little bit of heat to make it more liquid. There you can see it, that I push the colors against each other. Also against the molding dough. Filling in the gaps. There you can see it. And all the materials, what I always do, are listed in the beginning of this video and also in the description box with all the links where I buy my materials. Also the link to my Influencers Amazon store, so you can also check that out if you want to. And again, the people that already buy materials through my links, I appreciate it a lot, because I earn a little bit of money out of that, and it helps me to get to buy the supplies I need to make this geode or other paintings. So again, some heat. And the colors already bleed into each other. I like that. Now I'm trying to blow the colors over each other. Yeah, and this geode is about 45 by 55 centimeters, so it's a large one. There you can see that I blow the colors over each other. Adding a little bit of Bombay ink again against the fire glass. Yeah, and the first layer is only laying those colors down where I want my colors, and in the next layers I will hope to create some depth in another way than I normally do, and also some structure, because I like that also. It doesn't have to be totally flat. So I'm going to add some special materials to it. Again, some heat. And now the torch for the air bubbles. And then I'm almost done with the first layer. Then I'll have to let it dry and then I can start with the second layer. So it has dried for 24 hours and I can start with the second layer now. So again, I'm starting with a Bombay ink with some Bling It Red mixed into it on the outside of the fire glass. There you can see it. It dried okay. I'm using the Stone Coat Art Coat. And yeah, that's a very nice resin. It has a great finish, just like glass. I like that. So a line around the fire glass. And then again, the wild jasmine with the interference violet mixed in it to make a lighter shade. And in between those colors, I'm pouring some clear. And again, the wild jasmine with nothing mixed into it, against it. And you can already see that I placed some really nice crystals on the geode because I want to combine them in my geode, and I made them in the very amazing molds of Rebecca. Only one mold I used that I made myself, but the rest is made by the molds from Rebecca. She makes some really nice molds. I also will include her link to the website where you can buy them in the description box, so you can check that out. But they are amazing and they sparkle a lot, so yeah, if you want to see that, then you can go to her website. So I already started with some really nice glitter. This is the super shard glass glitter in the lilac color. It's very nice, very sparkly. And I mixed it in the resin. And all the way around I will put a line of this glass glitter. Also around the other one. Yeah, it's just like a fire glass because it has on one side a mirror and on the other side a color, and that also the fire glass has that. But yeah, these are smaller pieces, but it's very nice. So almost done with the line. Now a line of the purple sapphire around the really nice crystals, I made. So at the end of this video, also a close-up, then you can see that they sparkle a lot. Yeah, and next to it, the ultraviolet of Just Resin. Very thin line against the purple sapphire. And now again a glitter, but then the fusion glass glitter, and then in the violet color. So against the crystals, it will be all glitter. There you can see it. I take it out with my stirring stick and I push it against the crystals. So not on top of it, but all the way around. Now some clear next to the, oh no, that is not the clear, that is the purple sapphire, sorry for that. So a line next to the glitter, the purple sapphire. This is the clear. So next to it, the clear, so that it can the color can flow into the clear. Little bit of heat to make it liquid so that it can flow to each other. And now a lighter shade of the purple sapphire, so I mixed some interference violet in it. And now I'm filling in all the gaps with some clear. Pushing it against my barrier. And now again some heat, because I want to blow the color into the clear. There you can see it. So first heating it up and then blowing it over the blue purple. There you can see it. So I'm almost done with the second layer. And then again, I will let it dry and then I can start on a third layer. But first, letting it dry. And you will see now a close-up of this layer. So this is how it looks after the second layer. Yeah, and I'm very pleased because it sparkles a lot and I like those crystals I made in the molds of Rebecca very much. And I want to combine them in more projects I will make. There you can see them. Only the middle one I made myself, the mold, but the rest is all from the molds of Rebecca. There you can see the nice fire glass in two shades. Yes, it's very vibrant, these colors together. But I like it. Also the nice glass glitter and diffusion glitter. Now a little bit closer. There you can see the sparkle of the blinged red in the magenta next to the fire glass. There the glitter line. Super sharp glitter. I like it. The colors have blended nicely. But yeah, I want for the next part, I want to try something out to create more depth. I don't know if it works. If it works, then I will be happy. If it's not working, yeah, then I need to figure out how to save the piece. But yeah, we will find out. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done that already. And give me a thumbs up for this video. That will help me a lot. And if you have tips, comments or questions, you can place them under the video. Or also you can send me an email. My email address is in the description box. Also, all the materials I've used, I have provided the links in the description box. And also in my influencers Amazon store. I would be very happy if you can share one of my videos. And I want to thank you all for watching again. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.